America, black people are treated very much as the Vietnamese people or any other colonized people, because we're used, we're brutalized. The police in our community occupy our area, our community, as a foreign troop occupies territory. And the police are there not to, in our community, not to promote our welfare or for our security and our safety, but they're there to contain us, to brutalize us and murder us, because they have their orders to do so. And just as the soldiers in Vietnam have their orders to destroy the Vietnamese people, the police in our community couldn't possibly be there to protect our property, because we own no property. They couldn't possibly be there to see that we received the due process of law, for the simple reason that the police themselves deny us the due process of law. And so it's very apparent that the police are only in our community, not for our security, but the security of the business owners in the community, and also to see that the status quo is kept intact.
People aren't hip to that yet. They're not really aware, because they know some shit's going on in this country somewhere. But a lot of people out there don't know where it's at. They think it's the black people doing it. That all those riots are causing my life to be miserable in all areas, you know. And they really haven't focused in on the fact that it's the pigs and their mentors, the people who control the pigs, the power structure, those bald-headed businessmen at the Chamber of Commerce, you see? They're not turned on to that power structure. They just know that life is becoming increasingly miserable for everybody. But when they find out who it is that's causing the trouble, and who it is that's making life miserable, and who it is that's responsible for all their sons being murdered in Vietnam, when they get tuned into that, see, then they're all going to be just like the Panthers, because this is what we're tuned into. We see what's going on, and it's just a terrible, foul situation. More and more people are turning on to that, you see? So, I think that they're going to do the dog right here in Babylon.
When we first started, we had a police alert patrol, and we would patrol the community. If we saw the police brutalize anyone, we'd put an end to this. Usually, the police wouldn't brutalize anyone if we were on hand, because we were armed. And if the police arrested the individual, we'd follow him to the jail and bail the individual out, whether he was a Panther or not. And we would gain many recruits like this. So, therefore, the community started to say that, well, these people are really concerned about our welfare.
I think the basic reaction to a cat that like experiences a Panther, I don't mean who sees a guy go by in a black jacket or a beret. I mean a guy who sees the Panthers in action with their lives on the line. When he sees that's the end of it, you know, like he's either scared to death, or he's gonna never commit no more crimes, do nothing wrong, you know, he's gonna jaywalk, or else he comes down and comes around and says that he can dig it, you see? You don't find a guy, black cat, just remaining the same after really seeing the Panthers. The guys on the block out there, man, they never have been too impressed by America, you know, by what's been happening to them. They're not impressed by that. They don't stand in fear of the cops. And this is the reason, one of the reasons why the Panther Party focused on the cops. Because the cops are out there and they're visible, you see. And this is the direct contact of the black people with the power structure. You know, it's the man, the pig, who's gonna come and bother them, you see. But the only thing that has been lacking was a method by which to really move against it effectively. And those other organizations with those programs and those nonviolent tactics and those appeals to God and Allah and whoever, brothers didn't want to hear that. And so here, all of a sudden, here come two niggas with some guns, stand up in front of the cop and talk to the cop just like the cop's talking to them, you know. They check that out. They really want to know what that's about, you see? If they don't decide that their life is too precious, you know, that they must live forever. If they don't decide that, then they come a little close to the party.
not a self-defense group in the limited fashion that you usually think of self-defense groups. I would like to use an example. When Fidel Castro started the revolution along with Che Guevara, with 12 of them all together, they realized that they wouldn't be able to topple the oppressive regime in Cuba. What they were, essentially, was an educational body. They engaged with the army, they fought with the army, and they showed the people that the army was not bulletproof, that the police were not bulletproof, and that Batista's regime was not a regime that was impossible to topple. So the people started to feel their strength. The Black Panther Party feels very much the same way. We think that this educational process is necessary, and it's the people that will cause the revolution, and it's the people that will cause the change in the country. The Black Panther Party is simply the vanguard of the revolution, and we plan to teach the people the strategy and the necessary tools to liberate themselves.
No more brothers in jail.
Off the pig.
The pigs are gonna catch hell.
Off the pig.
No more brothers in jail.
Off the pig.
Trying to kill him, you see, it's for the people to become aware of what this is all about. This is why I like this idea about film, because people can get to know more about that. They can see things, you know. But the people have to stand up and demand, and they have to understand that they have a right. They have a right to demand that these judicial procedures be carried out in the right manner.
The revolution has come.
Off the pig.
Time to pick up the gun.
Off the pig.
The revolution has come.
Off the pig.
Time to pick up the gun.
Off the pig.
The revolution has come.
Off the pig.
Time to pick up the gun.
Off the pig.
The revolution has come.
Off the pig.
Time to pick up the gun.
Off the pig.
With the Peace and Freedom Party, which is primarily a white group. We see it necessary to fight on two fronts. We must liberate the colony as well as stimulate revolution in the mother country. Since I think that the revolutionary students play a great part in saving America. If it were not for the white students, the Black Panther Party would react to the racism in the country and therefore respond with racism. White students have been very interested in the past of the foreign policy of the United States. They're demanding that the United States withdraw from Vietnam, stop brutalizing the Vietnamese people. And we feel that the white students should relate and pay more attention to the colonized situation here of the blacks first, because after all, this is home. And they should, this is not to say that they shouldn't denounce America's treacherous actions abroad. I think they can be done at the same time, that it's just a matter of placing emphasis upon the criminal activities of America here in the homeland.
Let's get into the inner workings and the meaning of this. Let's get into the inner workings and the meaning of a black revolution and why black people have a right to take what's theirs. You can read the platform and the program.
And it's a basic program. And it simply says exactly what black people have been crying for 400 years. One, we want freedom. We want power to determine the destiny of our own black communities. Two, we want full employment for our people. Three, we want decent housing fit for shelter of human beings. Four, we want an end to the robbery of the black community by the white racist businessman. Five, we want decent education that teaches us about the true nature of this racist, decadent system. Education that teaches us about our true history and our role in the society and the world today. Six, we want all black brothers to be exempt from military service. Seven, we want an immediate end to police brutality and murder of black people. Eight, we want all black brothers and sisters held in federal, county, state, city, jails, and prisons to be released because they have not had a fair trial. They've been tried. They've been tried by all white juries who have no understanding of the average reasoning man in the black community. Number nine, this is where Brother Huey is being caught. We just want the courts to make sure we have peers on the jury or people from the black community as defined by their jive constitution, the so-called United States. The 10, the summary with the major political objective, that is, we want land, bread, housing, clothing, education, we want justice, we want peace. Major political objectives, we want a black plebiscite, the UN, the black colonial subjects will participate, dealing with, analyzing, projecting politically upon the racist atrocities that have been committed against black people in this nation. This basically. The whole black nation has to be put together as a black army. And we're gonna walk on this nation, we're gonna walk on this racist power structure, and we're gonna say to the whole damn government, stick 'em up, motherfucker. This is a hold up. We come for what's ours.